They know our strategies. They've learned our weaknesses. And the alien attack nearly destroyed us. That must never be allowed to happen again. If we're going to survive, we need a new kind of soldier. One who doesn't think the way we think. Fear the things we fear. One the enemy would never expect.
Welcome to Unit on Ender's Game. As you may have guessed from the title, games are very important in this novel, as are the idea of who's playing and what are the rules. Very important in this day and age, particularly with technology, where anyone can pretend to be anything through a keyboard. These themes of games and deception are very important in this day and age. Online, anyone can pretend to be, well, anyone or anything. And often students are unaware of the impact they are leaving behind and what they're choosing to reveal to people online. Students will learn about the drawbacks and benefits of living in a digital world. They will look at different avatars, mediums, privacy settings, and their own digital footprint, then create a video for younger students to learn. Students will learn about patriotism and propaganda, both through older speeches and through music found in different cultures. Students will examine similar themes, such as power, perception, and different mediums, for example, through films, through books, and through poems. Students will also examine the different characters. They'll create webs, as well as character tropes, and expand on those.
Buy it, use it, break it, fix it, trash it, change it, melt, upgrade it, charge it, point it, zoom it, press it, snap it, work it, quick erase it, write it, cut it, paste it, save it, load it, check it, quick rewrite it, plug it, play it, burn it, rip it, drag it, drop it, zip and zip it, lock it, fill it, curl it, find it, view it, code it, jump and lock it, surf it, scroll it, pose it, click it, cross it, crack it, switch, update it, name it, read it, tune it, print it, scan it, send it, fax, rename it, touch it, bring it, pay it, watch it, turn it, leave it.
The three main ISTE standards are 1. Creativity and innovation, 2. Communication and collaboration, and 5. Digital citizenship. The unit begins with a clip from Star Trek and a discussion of technology and war. Students will graph what social media the class uses most and create a T-chart about the positive and negative aspects of a digital world. The students will be divided into 5 groups, which they will remain in for the rest of the unit, and that night they will begin reading Ender's Game, chapters 1 and 2. Next class, students will create a list of characters they have encountered so far and put them into a Google Doc. For each character, the students should list at least 3 traits, loyal, vain, etc., for the first day. As they read, students should add to this list, and by the end of the novel, all minor characters should have at least 5 traits, and the major characters at least 20. Afterward, there is a discussion on bullying, particularly cyberbullying, what it means to be a good digital citizen. The 5 groups mentioned above will all be assigned a pair of themes. In their reading, the students need to find 3 quotes per chapter that relate to one of their words, put the quotes into Wordle. Next comes the discussion of privacy, where students look at the terms and conditions of websites they regularly use, discover what rights they have given up. Days 4 and 5 are about conquerors and internet research, including an instructional video. After being taught how to research, students will write an e-blog analyzing their conqueror of their choice, the person's successes or failures. Day 6 gives the students a choice between drawing symbols for the battle school teams on a sketch pad or writing a school song for battle school on Soundation. Here, students compare and contrast what they do in PE to what other students in other countries do, and compare that to battle school. There are two pre-selected students for the next part. One student reads instructions like, touch your nose, off an iPad, to a group of volunteers, one of whom is told beforehand to go along and influence the other volunteers. Then there will be a clip from the Dead Poets Society, a discussion about the concept of obedience. Now we've reached the midway point. The teacher will start by reading out loud Aussie Minus to the class. Most of the class period will involve acting out Chapter 9 as much as possible. For homework, the students will record themselves reading the poem over appropriate images and upload it to YouTube. Next class will open with Carl Sagan's Pale Blue Dot. The students will compare Pale Blue Dot, Aussie Midas, and Ender's Game using a Venn diagram. They'll discuss what it means to be real online, and the students will create an e-blog discussing power, perception, and perspective. They will have to read and comment on each other's blogs. The students will watch various persuasive speeches in class. After analyzing them, the students will write a persuasive speech of their own, convincing people of what they feel is important on VoiceThread. They will need to use Lucid Press to create a poster or symbol for their cause. The students will watch the opening to the film Chorus Line and write a response in Google Docs shared with the teacher. Then the groups will be assigned a character from the book to create a fake book account for. They need to consider what this person would share about themselves and respond to classmates. Then the students will discuss how people are judged online and make predictions about the assigned characters. They will discuss the consequences of sharing online, the idea of being someone else online, and the dangers of risky relationships. Finally, they shall create an Animoto video to teach elementary school children about the benefits and dangers of the digital world. Next comes patriotic and political music from around the world. Students will add to this list with songs of their own and create a Wordle using the lyrics, seeing which words or concepts are the most common. The students will watch Peter and the Wolf. Afterward, they will create a theme song for their assigned character using Soundation. Using the Battle Chronicle, students will map out a battle fought in the book and compare it to a battle fought by a historical general, analyzing the strategies and the technology. They will also write their final e-blog on their predictions versus what actually happened in the story. Last day, the students will compare the Wordle sheets they have been working on all unit and see which words come up the most often in regards to a theme. The students will then take their character sheets and put the information into an infogram. As a class, they will discuss which traits best fit each character and which ones show up the most overall. The students have two choices for what they want to do for their final project. A, they can do a group project using Movie Maker or similar software, acting out a scene that we did not witness in the book. Or B, an individual project. The student may use the character graphs created the last day and research character tropes and types. They will assign a trope to each character, create a presentation using Eastly or a podcast using VoiceThread, and present their theory to the class. The presentation must include outside research in comparison to real-life person. So why does this matter? Well, we know that computers are being used to fight wars, but beyond that, we need our students to know just how important, how powerful, how wonderful, and how dangerous the internet is. How awesome it is that you can make friends from every corner of the globe, that you can play a game with someone from Japan and Australia and Britain all at the same time. But also how dangerous it is that you can leave behind things that don't really reflect you, that what you say and do now may last forever, that not everything is as it appears, and you never really know who's behind the other keyboard. Students now need to know the importance and the power of privacy, perception, and what they do today. In this class, I learned how important it is not to tailor a class fit to my own methods of learning, but to make sure I have a wide variety so I can reach all of my students.